Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome back to the REDX podcast. We are so glad that you're here. Thanks for tuning in today, whether you're watching this live or afterwards on any of our podcast platforms. Thanks for tuning in. We're excited. We have a first-time guest with us today, Rick Fuller. Welcome, Rick.
Hey, thanks, Haley. Great to be with you.
Yeah, we're excited to have you. I'm excited to get into the conversation that we're going to have today. But before we do that, I just want to talk to the audience who is watching. If you want to chat in any questions throughout this podcast, we'll have somebody commenting, making sure that we can answer any questions that you have. We also have you can subscribe to our podcast wherever you listen to, or you can go to redx.com/podcast. We'll email you every time we have a new episode, all that good stuff. And on that web page, you can also find resources that we talk about, replays, things like that. It's a great place to go if, you like today's podcast. So Rick, before we get into the meat of our conversation today, could you just tell our audience a little bit about who you are for those that don't know who you are?
Sure, Haley. I'm a real estate broker in the San Francisco Bay in Sacramento County. We've got offices scattered throughout the Bay in Sacramento. We've been voted best by the Assembly of California and also the state Senate, recognized as a small business of the year, which was super, super cool. Got over 1,500 five-star reviews. We really, really care about the client's experience. We really, really care about the agent's experience. And so we're an endorsed local provider for Dave Ramsey. We've served thousands of people. It's been an incredible experience, and I'm just excited to talk to you today. I think we're talking about lead conversion.
Yes.
And there's a whole lot to that. And there's a lot of things our industry is doing wrong. Mm. And this is a way to kind of give you a process to do it right and effective.
Yes. I love it. I'm excited to get in the conversation. Sounds like you know what you're talking about. You've been in the business for a bit. So I'm excited. I do think that this conversation is so important. I think people will get, I mean, even just our customers here at REDX will get our leads and determine they don't work or determine our products don't work because they're not converting, right? And which there's multiple issues there of why aren't they converting? There could be multiple reasons. So I want to talk, we're going to talk a lot about lead conversion, how we can actually get those people to an appointment and then to a contract and then to closing, of course. So Rick, where should we start? Should we talk about like where agents go wrong with lead conversion, or you could—
Well, let's start there. You know, Haley, as I'm an Eisenhower coach with ICC Coaching and Consulting, and I hear the same thing over and over again. These leads suck. These leads are terrible. These leads don't work. And here's what I've realized. There are no bad leads. They're top funnel leads. There are no bad leads, they're top funnel leads. What do I mean about that is that not everybody is ready to sign a contract today. Not everybody is ready to hire a moving company and move into their next home today. That there's a process. And if you make the mistake of assuming a top funnel lead, they're not through the funnel yet, they're not ready to buy or sell yet, is a bad lead, you're mistaken. And many of you that are listening to this, including me, you've had that experience where you meet somebody walking down the street. They called you a year ago, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, whatever. And then you go, hey, how's it going? I know we haven't talked. And they go, oh, I'm great. I just moved into my new house. We're loving it. And you're like, I had the opportunity. They were not a bad lead 3 years previously. They were a top funnel lead. And there's a major difference between the two. And so if you're a real estate agent, where are we going wrong? We view them as bad leads, and we write them down on a cocktail napkin. We write it down on a yellow sheet of paper. We write, you know, we text ourselves. And what we should be doing is following an organized sales process, which involves moving our clients around the bases and not trying to hit a home run every time, but just trying to get them on first base, then to second, then to third, and then bring them home.
I like that because I think a lot of people, I mean, calling expired leads, for example, that is something that they're like, I'm trying to get business now. They're interested in selling their house. But we also offer old expireds, right? So people that might not have been in a situation where they wanted to relist or anything. So there's so many opportunities that if people are only looking for the bottom of funnel, people that are ready to look or ready to list right now, I mean, that's not how you build a sustainable business, right? You don't, you can't just focus on, I mean, you can focus on the low hanging fruit, but if that's all you're focusing on, you're just going to be in the grind forever and ever. And so.
So we're using the metaphor of a funnel.
Yeah.
And which is bigger in a funnel? Is it the top of the funnel or is it the bottom? Because last I checked, the top of the funnel is huge. The bottom of the funnel is very small.
Right.
And if you're only going to focus on the few people that are ready to buy and sell real estate this week, you are missing out on a huge opportunity. And there's an opportunity to nurture and to move those contacts to customers and customers to clients, clients to contract, and then contract to close. And so the top of the funnel is so much bigger, Haley, than the bottom. That's why we can't miss out on this opportunity.
I love it. So let's see how to get to first base. How do we do it?
Yeah. So, well, let's just use the metaphor of a baseball diamond.
Yeah.
And let's just say that you start off on home plate. You got a contact. What's a contact? It's a name. Maybe it's a name or phone number. Maybe you got them on REDX. Maybe you met them at the grocery store. Maybe it was at an open house, whatever. But it's just a contact. Now, a lot of people say it's a lead. I would tell you it's not a lead. It's just a contact. It's just somebody you put in your iPhone or whatever, and they're a contact. In order for them to go to first base, Haley, it's important that you define what a customer is. Because when they get to first base, they're a customer. And now that contact where you had a name and phone number, you had just a phone number, you had just an email. Now you got to get them to have five key components to be qualified as a customer sitting on first base. Here are those five. They got to have a name, a real name, Haley. And it can't be Mickey Mouse. It cannot be Do Not Call Me. It needs to be a real name. They have to have a real phone number. And it can't be 555-555-55555. It needs to be a real phone number. They got to have a real email address. And they got to want to buy now or in the future, buy or sell. And Haley, they either have not or are not a real estate agent. Like those are my five. Name, phone number, email address, want to buy now or in the future, have not or are not an agent. That makes them a customer. They're on first base. I'm not trying to hit a home run. I'm just trying to get my contacts to customers is all I am trying to do. And by the way, the consumer loves this because nobody wants a pushy salesperson.
Right.
They're just now interested in their in your community. They've been shopping on, you know, different websites for a property. The last thing they want is a pushy salesperson. They sign here, sign here, sign here. All we need to do is to make them a customer. Yep, they got a name, they got a phone number, they got an email address. They want to buy now or in the near future, and they have not or are not a real estate agent. That means they're a customer.
That's the conversation, and then that's it, right? Like that's the goal is to just get them there, ask them those questions, and then you made it to first base.
Well, let's make it even easier, Haley. If I could just role play with you real quick, would use this, what I call the If I Found script. Which if you dissect this If I Found script, guess what you come out with? Five things. Name, phone number, email address, want to buy now or in the near future, have not or are not an agent. So I'd say, Haley, great to meet you today. Hey, I'm just curious. If I found a home that fit exactly what you're looking for, would it be okay if I reached out with you?
Sure.
And you'd say?
Yeah, of course.
I mean, Haley, I'm in an office. We got properties coming across our desks all the time. We got lots of real estate agents. There's lots of properties coming on the market. I'm actively touring homes every week. I mean, if the perfect home came across my desk, could I contact you with it, Haley?
Yeah, I would love that.
Great. And then I'd go to Haley, and for the sake of time, I'd say, Haley, tell me what a perfect property is for you. What are you looking for? And I would take it deep. I'd say, why is that important to you? Why is that important to you? Why is that important? Oh, I want a big kitchen. Why is that important? Well, we hold a lot of parties. Oh, I want a great family room. Why is that important to you? Well, we do the Super Bowl at our house. I want a big backyard. Okay, whatever. I want to be next to this school, park. In this community, I want to be on this side of the track. Like I'm going to get that detailed information. Then I'm going to say, great, Haley, if that particular property falls on the market, you wanted me to reach out to you. What's the best phone number to call you? And can I have an email to send you the digital pictures? And you'd say,
I'd give it to
you. You'd give me your name and phone. Now this script, the If I Found script, if I found a home that fit exactly what you're looking for, is it okay if I reach out to you? Gives you the name, phone number, email address, want to buy now or in the near future, have not or on an agent, because if they weren't interested in hearing from you, they'd say, oh, no, my sister's an agent. Oh, no, we never plan to buy. I'm not giving you my email. I'm not giving you my phone number. See, that script, the If I Found script, and you could use that in any capacity. By the way, It's real, it's authentic, and it's what people want. They want that perfect home. And guess who's the conduit? The real estate professional. That perfect home goes through the real estate professional to that consumer when the agent's doing their job. The If I Found script does this beautifully.
I love that. And it's simple. It's not too complicated. You're not on the phone forever. It's pretty
simple. Try it. Next time you're in the grocery store, it's a whole lot more convenient and easy and authentic. People aren't looking for fake stuff today. Don't give them a script about something that, you know, can I get your name and phone number just so I can tell the owner that you came through my open house, but you have no intentions of telling the owner. Can I get your name and phone number so I can tell the owner I didn't go golfing today at an open house? Like, you have no intentions of, just tell them, just say, hey, if I found a home that fit exactly what you're looking for, could I reach out to you? And that produces more customers. It's easy to remember. You can have that conversation in any place that you're at. It's not weird. It's not awkward. It's very transparent, and it's a win-win. Win for you. You define who's a customer. You move that contact to first base, and then it's a win for them.
I love it. And it's just first base, right? We're going to talk about how to get around the bases here. But I love like what you said about it being authentic. It's what people want to talk about. It's what people want to hear. It's such a easier conversation than, hey, can I, you know, like if you're calling an expired or something like that, who doesn't know you or anything, it's a little bit more salesy, right? So I like this.
And you know, Haley, when you talk about expired, because I know REDX provides a lot of incredible expired contacts. Sometimes what's going to get that expired seller to move is another home. That's what's going to propel them to really do what's necessary in order to prepare the property, in order to price the property. So this script works with them.
Yeah.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Expired. I'm just curious, if I found a home that fit exactly what your next home that you're looking for, would you like me to reach out to you? Great. You're able to reach out to them in the same way. Nobody wants to sell. Everybody wants to buy. Selling is a means to an end. That's the problem real estate agents have. We think that everybody wants to sell. Are you ready to sell? Nobody wants to sell. Why would I want to sell my home? All my memories are in it. All my equity's in it. My retirement account's in it. But everybody wants to buy. And so buying is what is the lead measure. Selling is the necessity in order for me to afford to buy. When you look at it this way, this is not a buyer script. This is a great expired script. This is a great for sale by owner script. This is a great family member script. It works. It's real, it's authentic, and it's genuine. And now I know Haley is no longer a contact. She is a customer. And now I know that you have those five criteria: name, phone number, email address, want to buy now or in the near future, have not or are not an agent. Congratulations, Haley, you're a customer.
Amazing. So then to get to the next base, let's talk about that. Like what you need to get in order to get there. What is this, a different conversation? Is this later? Talk to me about that.
Yeah. So, you know, you have customers, like if you and I were to go shopping today for like a flat screen TV, you know, I know your broadcast is national, but maybe we go to Costco, maybe we go to Sam's Club, maybe we go to Walmart, maybe we go to Target. I don't know. Maybe we go to Best Buy if you got those. Like, we're a customer, right? And there's nothing wrong with that. But what we want is we want clients. Yes. We want people that say, I am no longer a customer. I can go to that agent, that agent, that agent, that agent, that agent, that open house, that open house, that open. I call all these agents and have them show me property. I want a client who then says, that's my real estate professional. And now I've removed them from the market. I don't need them to close escrow. I don't need them to deposit the commission in my bank account yet. I just want them to say, I'm a customer, and now Rick's my agent. Haley's my agent. And I'm exclusive to Haley. You know, if you ever tried, you or I ever tried to do the same thing when we shop for a flat screen TV with a powerful attorney, like we go to an attorney and we say, I'm interviewing five or six different attorneys and I plan to use all of them for my legal challenge. How many of those top attorneys are going to take you up on that? None. How many of the top CPAs going to say, oh yeah, I'll go ahead and process your taxes, and if you like the bottom line, you can pay me. Or if you mm-hmm. like the results I come up with, you can pay me. Real estates do this. Real estate agents do this all the time. And there's one thing that we have really clearly come out of with all the litigation that's happening nationally is you must have a client. And a client comes with a contract. And in a buyer case, that's a buyer representation agreement, a buyer broker agreement, whatever you call it in your market. And if it's a seller, it's probably some version of a listing agreement. Both of these say, hey, you and I are agreeing to be in a client relationship. You're now a fiduciary for me. I'm going to take good care of you, my VIP clients. For you, you now know that I am looking out after your best interest as your real estate professional. And now I have a client.
I like that. I think a lot of people, I mean, you think, I keep going back to this expired example, so I'll just keep doing that. But when an expired hasn't sold their home, right? Sometimes it's because the agent couldn't get the job done or the agent wasn't what they wanted them to be or didn't do enough or whatever their expectations were. And so a great strategy when talking to these people is to tell them what you're going to do differently that is going to earn that commission instead of just, oh, but my other agent said they do the same things and obviously it didn't work out. So I like this bringing up the value that you bring, instead of just, you know, like you were talking about CPAs and stuff like that. Because it's so, I mean, I think about it when just, if I were to sell my home, like it's a lot of money to give somebody who you might like. The perception of agents can also be like, oh, they don't do much. They're just trying to sell, especially if the market is hot, all that stuff. Anyway. So I like making sure that you show them your value and then you get their loyalty. Right. And that's really the most important part. I like it. I'm just writing down on this baseball diamond on my notepad here of all the stuff to talk about. This is awesome. What else, what other things are important when going from a customer to this client?
Yeah, well, so we need to make customers clients. That's the exclusivity part.
Right.
They're now exclusive to me. I'm now focused on their best interest. By the way, it allows me to prioritize. I remember when I first got in the business and I learned this, my mentor, my coach used to say, how many clients do you have, Rick? And I'd stand up and I'd say, I'm working with this person and that person and that person. And they'd say, show me the buyer representation agreement. Show me the listing agreement. They'd say, sit down. You do not have any clients. All you have is customers. So what happens is when I have a client, I'm now able to prioritize my time. How much availability do I have this evening, this weekend, this Saturday, this Sunday to show properties? I'm able to prioritize my time. Who am I going to call Monday with all those Monday updates that are required? And this allows me as a real estate professional to really prioritize my time. It also allows me to quantify my business. Because, you know, Haley, if you say I have a lead, and you know that I hate that term, I use the word, you know, customer or client.
Right.
Leads are all over the board. Some leads are ready to close escrow in 30 to 45 days. Other leads are several years out.
Right.
Leads come from different sources. Some leads are top funnel, some are middle funnel, some are bottom funnel. But when you have a customer, you now have a quantifiable business. Now, here's what we found. We built an entire department around this. For every 10 customers I have, not leads, not prospects, not even contacts, for every 10 customers, as I've defined it, we will close one escrow. So if I want to sell 500 homes in a year, I need 5,000 customers. It's that simple. And I'm going to do what's necessary. Now, there might be a lot more contacts in there, but I'm going to do what's necessary to get those 5,000 customers to serve 500 families, to sell 500 homes. I know that conversion rings true. And maybe if you have better systems and processes than we do, maybe it's 1 in 8 or 1 in 7. We have discovered for the last several years, it's 1 in 10. And every time I monitor that from a customer, my business and my agent's businesses are now quantifiable.
It makes me think about all where agents go wrong in this system. Because I mean, when you're going from a customer to a client here, that is like, the most crucial lead conversion, right? This is when you are turning them from someone that you, I mean, you know, information about them, you know, their name, your email address, like the five things that we talked about, but this is when they're really becoming committed. And would you say that this is like the most important lead conversion part? And if so, like where do agents go wrong in this moving from first base to second base?
Yeah. Well, they skip it. They just try to be a home run hitter, don't we? You know, all steps, you know, you don't cross the finish line unless you cross first, second, and third base. All of them are important. But I think what happens is agents just try to hit a home run. They just swing for the fences every time. They want to hit it 400 feet out of, you know, the park. And what ends up happening when you do that, you lose so many of the people who just aren't ready. They're at the top of that funnel. And if we could just nurture them with an organized sales process, they'll cross the finish line with somebody. The question is whether it's going to be with you. And in this step, there's a lot of tools that can help us. Now, I do a lot of work with AI, artificial intelligence. So before we jumped on this podcast, I jumped into ChatGPT and I simply wrote, as a prospective home buyer, ChatGPT-4, as a prospective home buyer, what are the five biggest reasons that you should not buy a home today? And of course, ChatGPT loads me up with all the reasons why, as real estate professionals, things we've heard, right? Like it's telling me, ChatGPT says, you shouldn't buy a home today because interest rates are higher. You shouldn't buy a home today because inventory is lower. You shouldn't buy a home today because prices are higher. You shouldn't buy a home today, you know, because it might need work or maintenance or requirements, or you might need a larger down payment. Like it lists all these things out, all the reasons not to buy a home. Then I type into ChatGPT, as a professional trusted advisor, disarm every one of those five objections you just gave me. And then it populates and it does a brilliant job. Then I asked for it to add a call to action. So when it came to high interest rates, it said, you know, people that are saying don't buy because of high interest rates. When it comes to high interest rates, it was saying, by buying in today's market, you allow yourself to lock the rate, securing the same mortgage payment that you've had for a very long time. When it came to high prices, it said time in the market is more important than timing of the market. So get into the real estate market because it's better to hold property and keep it than it is to try to time it at this perfect timing. And, you know, how's the stock market doing and what's our inventory level? Like it's better to time in the market supersedes timing the market. When it talked to home improvements, it talked and concerns that I might have to make repairs to a property. ChatGPT goes on to say, well, we'll get a home inspection and we'll get a roof inspection. We'll do a termite inspection. We'll validate the property is structurally sound. So biggest objections, then ChatGPT disarms all of those suggestions or obstacles, replaces it with a sound reason. I don't even need to come up with these scripts anymore. I can use AI. Now, AI is not going to replace you as the agent. It's not going to replace me as the agent. But if I'm using it right, it empowers me. I did that in 30 seconds right before we jumped on the call.
Right.
How long would it have taken for me to type up all of those objections and then the response to those objections? And then why don't we take those five and shoot a video? That's what I'm going to do today. I'll take those same five. I'll shoot a video saying, hey, I know a lot of people are concerned about this objection. Have you thought about this? Have you considered this? And I'll give the response to that objection. Why not use it? Why not use it to make it into an email or a blog post or a Facebook post or whatever you want to do? Here's the point. You can leverage AI to come up with some of the responses, first the objections, and then the response to those objections that will help you better make your customers clients.
I love this because I think we talk to agents about AI and it's exciting about all the things that you can do with it, but I haven't heard the strategy really of like making your conversations better with it, right? Using it to make your conversations better. Because people are like, oh, I'll write my listing descriptions. I'll write some emails and follow-up sequences, which it's great for that. But like you said, it will never replace the one-on-one conversation that you have with somebody. but it can help. If you have all of this information at your disposal, like, oh, here, I know you're probably worried about this. Let's handle that objection before it's even an objection or something or like that. I love that you're using it to, I mean, that is what stops people from calling REDX leads is because of those objections, right? And they're unsure of what to say. And if you are prepared with answers and knowledge and things like this. And sometimes we get wrapped up in words or don't know how to say certain things and it can help you with that. It's a game changer and it makes you more confident. That will translate to the homeowner as well. If you're like, oh, this guy knows what he's doing, you know?
The agent that's not empowered by AI, not to replace them, to empower them. Hmm. Is missing out on a huge opportunity because AI is so much more than write my property description. Help me soften up this email. Yes. I'm about ready to send. It is so much more than that. I believe that AI can help you become 10 times more effective as a real estate professional. When you're armed, whether you're using a Microsoft Copilot or a Google Gemini, or you're using Claude or Perplexity or what I talked about today, ChatGPT. I mean, I teach all of these in our AI Advantage course at Eisenhower, but there's so many more ways that you can use it that really empower you. And here's the problem. We live in a tunnel, don't we? We think like real estate agents. We act like real estate agents. We respond like real estate agents. And the moment you go to like a ChatGPT, you start hearing, I think, what are real, authentic, out-of-the-box challenges that people have. And there are legitimate, authentic, trustworthy responses. I mean, I know this, not owning real estate is really hazardous to your wealth. Like, I want my people to own real estate. I want my clients to be able to sell a home and buy that next property because their home matters. Like, I know these things are true, but all these obstacles kind of get in the way, or they discourage me, or they frustrate me, or whatever. And this can be an easy tool that you can use to decipher those, to give you the responses in real time, to empower you to have those conversations with your customers who are now going to be clients.
I love it.
Can we go to contracts?
Yes, please.
Because I don't know a real estate professional that doesn't want to have more in contract, more pending.
Yes.
So once you have a client, now they're exclusive to you, your goal, singularly focused, is to find them a new home or to sell their property. Either way, you want to bring them a seller or you want to bring them a buyer. And we need to move them into contract. Now, contract is a little bit different perspective than the others because now we're bringing in this third party. It's me and a buyer. It's me and a seller. And now it's me and a buyer and I'm bringing in a seller. Mm-hmm. It's me and a seller and I'm bringing in a buyer. And it's my job to find them. It's my job to market for them. My job to advertise for them. My job to, you know, to decipher the difference between some of the good ones and some of the bad ones. But they now become in contract. And then, of course, once you're in contract, we're rounding we're at third base and we're trying to round this to home. And now we want to close. We want to close escrow. And that's, by the way, when you get the 6C, which is a commission. And yes, we want to close escrow. And if you're a real estate professional, whatever you call it in your market, whether it's contingencies or subject tos or appraisals or home inspections or termite reports or surveys or whatever, you know that there are obstacles, and your ability to think, okay, now I have somebody in contract. I must overcome those obstacles to help them close escrow, to be able to accomplish their dream of home ownership or from transitioning to one home to the next.
Hmm. I like this. I'm a baseball fan, so I love this visual. I'm curious. I mean, we're out of time. Wow. That went by really fast. But before we close up, I mean, we talked about how to get to home base. Is there any other like quick AI tricks just from like second to third to fourth that you use, you leverage AI for these specific steps that you could share with us in a couple minutes?
Oh, 100%. Let's use the negotiator found in ChatGPT to negotiate. Like literally this will tell you, write it in, type in, I'm in a negotiation. There's five others that have made an offer on this property. They're asking this amount. I'm going to offer this amount. Here are my terms. role play the negotiation with the negotiator, which is a GPT availability on ChatGPT, OpenAI. You go to OpenAI, go to ChatGPT, go to explore GPTs, type in the negotiator. It will tell you how to negotiate. And that's a big part of now they're a client. We want them to become in contract, right? Then what you can do using things like Perplexity. Perplexity is brilliant at data. It's not all that good at discussion or conversation. I like ChatGPT for that, but Perplexity is really good at data. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in my client is looking at a property and, you know, on Main Street, USA, whatever your neighborhood community is, what has been the average property sell for? What is the average property list at? What is it? What's the average list price versus sales price ratio? It has it. It will populate. So when my seller says, I'm not making an offer at list price, Uncle Wijakowski said I should make an offer $50,000 below on everything that I write. And you're like, no, that's not what the market is. The moment you can come to them and say, Mr. and Mrs. Buyer, the average property in this particular neighborhood sells for $5, $10, $15, $20,000 above the list price. Maybe for some of you, it's $40, $60, $80, $100,000 above the list price. So I know you may have had some concerns with that. I thought I would share this information with you before we talked about price. Like, you're completely disarming that conversation all by using Perplexity. Or jump on Google Gemini, which Gemini is linked Google to YouTube. So, you know, all those YouTube videos we've been launching all these years and they've been transcribed, Google has that. So, you know, I work with Eisenhower Coaching. Brian's got tons of videos. He's got 600 podcasts and blogs on the real estate market. Link it to your favorite communicator. If you like the way I'm talking about, put in, based on what Rick Fuller has to say, tell me, how do I respond to this situation? Based on what Brian Eisenhower has to say and all the videos he's posted and all the blogs he's done and all the podcasts he's done and all the stuff that's out there on the internet, Google Gemini will link that up. It has direct contact to YouTube and will provide some of those responses. It's a different era that we live in today, Haley. And the agent that's not powered by AI will become like the agent that's not powered by the internet. It'll be weird. It will be, they'll lack the power that they need, and they won't have the empowerment to win in a global market. You and I are not competing in local markets anymore.
Right.
We're competing in global spaces, and those people that have an advantage win. And this is designed to give you the AI advantage. That's why I call it AI agent advantage on all the work that we do, because it's I want the agent to come first. And then I want them to be powered by AI. And then I want them to have an advantage in the marketplace.
AI agent advantage. I love all your alliteration and the acronyms. I started my career as a copywriter, so I really appreciate that. But awesome, Rick. Thank you so much. I took a whole page of notes just from everything that we've talked about today. I think it's really going to help agents. And if they're not leveraging AI to really give them that empowerment to really go and check it out and figure it out and see what, because there's no limits to what you can do with it. And so I love this. We taught them how to really not just focus on home runs, but to really build your database, build that top of funnel that will definitely serve your career. So thanks, Rick. For people, like, where can they find you? Where can they find more information about you?
Yeah, if you want to follow me on social media, go to connectwithrickfuller.com. Connectwithrickfuller.com is where all my social media is, all our podcasts, videos, links, Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff. And if you're interested in the Agent AI Advantage program, just go to Eisenhower Coaching. And they have it there. Those are the modules. I talk about all of these things and a whole lot more. But I actually give you, Haley, what I call prompt threads. They're not prompts. You know, when you type into ChatGPT, you get like a question or a prompt. I build prompt threads because if you and I were at a networking event, like, it doesn't do us any good to have only one question. Like, you got to be able to have lots of questions
follow-ups,
to be able to carry on a dialogue.
Right.
Otherwise, weird and awkward. So I give you, like, whether it's ChatGPT on any topic, whether you're building out your sphere of influence, lead conversion, farming, whatever it is, I build out the prompt threads for you. So you just copy, paste, and drop it into your preferred AI. And then you get the response based on your markets, your dynamics, and how you've customized ChatGPT for you. All that's found at Eisenhower Coaching or agentaiadvantage.com.
Awesome. Yeah, we'll have those links below for anybody that's interested. Rick, thank you so much. I feel like we could keep going, so we'll definitely need to have you back, have more conversations like this. I love chatting with you. So thanks so much to everybody that is watching or listening. Thank you for tuning in. Like I said before, you can go to redx.com/podcast and get all of the goodies there, recordings, and also sign up for reminders. Thank you so much again, and we'll see everybody same time, same place next week. Bye-bye.